Hey YouTube, welcome back. My name's Mori. Did you know that despite these four villagers returning to Animal Crossing New Horizons in the 2.0 update, there are still 25 exclusive Animal Crossing villagers in the franchise that were never released outside of Japan and have yet to return to modern Animal Crossing games. Azalea, Chabwick, Fret, and Roswell used to be exclusive to Japan in the Animal Crossing E Plus version until they finally returned to Animal Crossing 20 years later and were eventually added to New Horizons. This was the first time these could be encountered outside of Japan, but the same can't be said for the other 25 villagers whose names were never even translated into other languages. So here are 25 Animal Crossing villagers you'll probably never meet. Cranky. Now, starting with Cranky villagers, we have Joe the Bird, Jubei the Lion, and Weldon the Bull, excluding the Big Sister and Smug personality type, as they weren't introduced until New Leaf. Cranky is the smallest subset of villagers, so it makes sense there's only three Cranky villagers who are exclusive to Japanese games. Normal. Now, moving on to normal villagers, we have Carrot the Cow, Clara the Hippo, Patricia the Rhinoceros, who apparently has watermelon horns, and Sunny the Frog. As you probably know, normal villagers are often referred to as sweet villagers, and if it's not a crime that Carrot has since been replaced with Maple on the cover art for KK Marathon, it's definitely a crime that Sunny has never been released outside of Japan and never returned to a modern Animal Crossing game, given how adorable she is. Jock. Next up, we have a bunch of Jock villagers, including Analog the Penguin, Fruity the Duck, Jen the Sheep, Kit the Squirrel, Massa the Dog, Nindori, who is probably the most recognizable of the exclusive villagers simply for those gyroid style eyes, who is an ostrich, Pierre the Cat, Poco the Bear Cub, who according to Nintendo themselves is the son of Ike the Bear, Shinabiru the Duck, Shokichi the Bird, and last but not least, Taroru the Wolf, who I'm pretty sure is the only Jock Wolf in the game. Now, Jock is the largest personality type in Animal Crossing with a total of 79 villagers, which is over 16% of the animals in the game, so it makes sense so many Jock villagers remain exclusive to the older Japanese games. With that said, much like Carrot, we have to feel sorry for Fruity, who used to appear on the cover art for KK Dixie before being replaced by Bill. Ouch. Peppy. Moving on, we have Peppy villagers including Koharu the kangaroo, Megumi the dog, and Meow the cat, who is of course inspired by meow lingual cat translation devices that have been popular over the years in Japan. Now again, Peppy is one of the smallest personality type subsets, so it makes sense only three Peppy villagers are included in this list. With that said, Marcy is the only other Peppy kangaroo, I believe, who, although released in Western versions of Animal Crossing, never returned past the GameCube version, so I think it's time a Peppy kangaroo returned to the series. Lazy. Next up, we have Lazy villagers, including Isle, the bear cub, and Bao the dog, who is of course Meow's counterpart, given they are also inspired by Baolingual, the dog equivalent of the pet translation devices. Anyway, although I'm sure we'd all welcome these two Lazy villagers, it makes sense Nintendo weren't in a rush to release these, given there are already plenty of Lazy cubs and Lazy dogs available. Snooty. And finally, we have Snooty villagers including Lulu the Anteater, not to be confused with Lulu the Hippo from the GameCube, and Madame Rosa the Bird. Interestingly, these two Snooty villagers are probably even rarer than some of the others we've mentioned today because they are considered islanders, so you can only move to the animal island rather than moving into your town. Oh, and those with super keen eyes may have already spotted Madame Rosa earlier in the video. Comment below if you saw her. So there we have it. These are the 25 villagers that not only remain exclusive to Japan, but will never return to the Animal Crossing franchise since the GameCube era. If you made it to the end of the video, be sure to post some villagers in the comments just to let me know you did, and be sure to include which villager you'd pick to return to Animal Crossing in the future if you could only pick one. I'd love to know. Thank you so much to the Patreon and channel members for supporting this content. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.